I think vegan gains wrecked me.
This is a world. This is a world premiere. This is a world.
First of all, Vegan Gains, I want to thank you for making a response video. My channel could definitely use the exposure, and I'm certain that many of your viewers are perfectly reasonable people who will get some value or entertainment out of my channel. And for folks who just enjoy a good battle, that's what turns you on. Cool. Thanks for the engagement. Also, welcome to the new viewers and subscribers. Richard, I also want to apologize for anything that I said that may have been untrue or that was hurtful to you. That wasn't my intention. Especially in regards to you identifying as part of the alt-right. I was basing that more on things that other people had said than on any real investigation, and that was wrong of me. I was actually relieved that you denied that and glad that you were willing to agree that they are a hateful organization. Thank you. But dude, chill. You seem to have taken my video as an out-and-out attack, which is reasonable as you don't know me and what motivates me, even though you seem to think you do. I've likely watched many more of your videos than you have of mine, so you had to base your opinions on assumptions about me, based on your feelings about feminist and leftist, instead of based on my body of work, which is pretty damn huge. Like my face. In this camera right now. It's certainly your right to have an opinion about me. I wish you had spent more time addressing my questions, but I got the impression that because you see me as a leftist, a retard, and a slew of other amusing pejoratives. Which brings me to this criticism. When we put so much emphasis on policing the manner with which ideas are presented, these rules and this demerit system based on infractions that you use a lot, calling out logical fallacies, categorizing ideas under familiar and often derogatory labels, accusing people of virtue signaling. There's so much jargon, I'm like, what are we even talking about? Was it ad hominem or ad nauseam or carpe diem or what? It makes having a simple conversation pretty difficult. It sends the message that only some people are authorized or even qualified to speak. That's not very productive, at least not in my opinion. I value facts as much as the next person, but I also understand that facts aren't neutral. You can be absolutely right about a subject, but if you only present part of the story, then facts can be misleading. And if it's done intentionally, then that's pretty dishonest. Not that you're attempting to mislead people. That's why I don't find it valuable to refute you. I encourage you to think about your facts in the context of the world. Events you call obscure and relating only to the third world take on a greater significance when you broaden the scope within which you consider them. Like the March 17th bombing in Mosul that killed 200 civilians, including 90 women and children that were in the basement of a building. If you want to paint me as irrational, appealing to emotions, retarded, unmanly, that's your right. If you want to make fun of my face too close to the camera, that's also your right. It does conveniently let you off the hook for dealing with me as a full human being, capable of my own thoughts and reasoning with my own experiences, capable perhaps of the curiosity that led me to ask the questions and draw the conclusions that I asked and drew in my previous video. It also makes a great smokescreen covering the fact that you never answered my questions. You say you also like to go after bad ideas. That's a worthy ambition. How about the current climate change denial going on in the Trump administration? How about the alt-right? Again, I think it's positive you denouncing that movement, but how about making a video explaining why you think white nationalism is a bad idea? Your viewers might find that as something useful. How about the international rise of fascism, demonstrated by the current popularity of certain political figures, not just Donald Trump, Jimmy Akerson in Sweden, Marine Le Pen in France, Hugo Chavez in Venezuela, Dutch politician Geert Wilders, Norbert Hofer in Austria? Did I mention Donald Trump? How about increased militarization and US plans to increase the US military budget? By $50 billion to over $600 billion when the US military budget is already as large as the next 7 countries' military budgets combined. How about restarting the nuclear arms race when there are already enough nuclear weapons stockpiled in the US and Russia alone to destroy the planet several times over? Did I mention capitalism, a system that depends on infinite growth when we live on a planet with finite resources? None of these ideas, by the way, are are good for the animals. I understand fear of terrorism and wanting to see an end to it. I understand the desire to scapegoat certain groups because their ideas frighten you. I'm sure these ideas frighten a lot of people. Sticking your head in the sand over other factors that are destroying the planet just because it's more convenient to only focus on the animals or Islam doesn't make those things go away. I don't even know if mass protests will make those things go away. But categorically labeling and demonizing the protesters certainly won't help. Making a video about me certainly won't help. Me making a video about you doesn't help. No, Vegan Gains, I don't think you're a bad person, and I'm sorry that that's what you took away from my video and for any negative feelings that my video may have caused you. I don't think you have to be seen as a bad person for me to feel good about myself. I don't think you need to be proved wrong for my points to be valid. I don't think you need to be destroyed for me to feel secure about myself or my big face in the camera. If it gives some people pleasure to see me as a super villain that you can wreck, I'm happy to provide that entertainment. Again, thanks for responding. That's it for this video. Like it if you like it. Share, comment, subscribe. This is Reg signing off. Love yourselves. Peace. And I love myself. The world is a ghetto because of me.